Welcome to Lapeer Community High School's 2013 Honor and Commencement Ceremony. Yeah, that's right. Actually, you can remain standing. It is we're very, very fortunate at Community High School, as many of our students know, to have an accomplished singer as part of our staff. So please join me in welcoming Mrs. Cindy Tanke, who will be singing the National Anthem, and Senior Lauren Young, who is an American Sign Language student, which is something that's been brand new at Community this year, who will be interpreting the National Anthem for us tonight. So please stand with our graduates, dignitaries. Gentlemen, if you would please remove your hats as Mrs. Tanke sings and Lauren Young interprets our National Anthem. I have to say that we had always had the National Anthem played on a disc, and then one year we had technical difficulties, and Mrs. Tanke stepped up and sang that with no accompaniment, and has been a fixture ever since. We're very fortunate, and Lauren Young, phenomenal job as well. So thanks again. I want to welcome family and friends, our board members, administration, Lapeer Community High School staff, and of course our graduates. I'm Kevin Walters, and I'm the proud principal at Lapeer Community High School. Thank you. This is truly a special event and represents a rite of passage beyond the walls of our school buildings and into the real world. There are several people who need to be acknowledged for their presence tonight, and I'd like to start by acknowledging the students that are graduating in the class of 2013. Also participating in our ceremony tonight is our superintendent of schools, Mr. Matt Wandry. And members of our Lapeer Community Schools Board of Education. There's another group of individuals whose tireless efforts have helped our graduates gain the success necessary to bring them here tonight. And I would like to ask our individual staff members to rise as I present them to you tonight. Kathy McKee. Kathy's been the coordinator of student services and has been a member of the community high school staff since 1997. N- None of our graduates were born then, I don't think. We're getting close, Mrs. McKee. All of us are. Mrs. Tanky, Cindy Tanky. Not only does she have a beautiful voice, but she also has the ability to teach math and English for us and has been a member of community high school staff since 1999. Mr. Don Shaver. Mr. Shaver teaches all of the science classes at community high school. He's been a member of the community staff since 2001. Mr. Bill O'Brien. That's right. OB is always dressed for the affair, as we know. Bill's been our 9th and 10th grade English teacher. He's been a member of the community staff since 2004. Mr. Rod Shook. Mr. Shook has taught social studies and PE, and he's been a member of the staff at community high school since 2005. Mr. Norman couldn't make it tonight. He had, unfortunately, a family commitment out of town, but he has been with us since 2008. He teaches math in E2020. Kelly Wagner. Wags. Mrs. Wagner is our outstanding art teacher. She's been a member of the community staff since 2008. She pays me to say that every year. She does. See? That's right. It's all about the money. Mr. Doug Grover. That's right. Doug does an absolutely phenomenal job working in our special needs department, and he joined our staff in 2009. We have a couple of other staff members, professional staff members, couldn't make it tonight. Brittany Adams, who has worked between Lapeer East and Community all year in American Sign Language. And Mr. Jake Weingartz, who is out of town as well tonight. He's worked part-time between Lapeer East and Community High School, teaching social studies and phys ed. Very good. Karen Reidenauer, our secretary. Everyone knows Mrs. Reidenauer. So Karen is just phenomenal. And having been in this business as long as I have, every day is a challenge, and if you don't have the right person at the front desk, it gets difficult at times. And let me tell you, we're fortunate every day that we have the right person there. That's Karen. Fantastic. Kim, yes, absolutely. And she did not pay me to say that. So, Kim Carlson, I don't think Mrs. Carlson's here today. She provides support for our students. I'd also like to recognize our police liaison officer. He has met a couple of our students during the year. We'll talk about that during senior bios. But that's Dave Hill. He's at the Lapeer County Sheriff's Department. He's an outstanding resource. Dave's a great guy. That's right. You won't find a better guy than Dave Hill. And he advocates for our kids nonstop, and we really appreciate him. As well as Michelle Etzen, who has been with our program and providing social work on behalf of the district as well. Other valued members of our team, and I'm so pleased that they're here tonight, Mr. John Wilson. Where's John? That's right, hiding in the back. Mr. Wilson is our custodian, and if you get a chance to go in that building and take a look at what that guy does every day and the pride he takes in the work, and if you take a look at his door and you see all of the face in the hole pictures, he's everything from the Marlboro Man to Danica Patrick in a race car. The kids have a good time, but John's an integral part of what we do, as is Miss Joyce Fisher, who's here today, who's our head cook. Absolutely. Feeding the students, very important, keeping them happy. And the staff, some staff members. Many people, parents, grandparents, family members, and friends sitting in our audience, and those who were unable to be here, have made tonight possible. Your love and encouragement has supported these graduates through good times and bad, and there have been both. We know that. Your belief and investment in them has contributed to their success amid their individual struggle that will continue to be a part of all of our lives. Over the past 4 years as a building principal at Community, I've typically taken a few minutes to provide our graduates with some inspiration through the actions and words of others. Tonight, I'll be a little less inspiring and maybe a little more challenging. Walt Disney. Everybody knows Walt Disney. He's widely known for the empire that he built. One of my favorite Walt Disney stories involves his artists and cartoonists that were challenged by Walt Disney to produce creative and impactful cartoon characters as they worked. And it's important. The group of students you see in front of you is probably the most artistic, talented group of students that we've had. Kelly paid me to say that too. The inspiring story of the artist that arrived at work after a frustrating previous day to find drawing paper that had been crumpled up and thrown away in the trash when they left was now taped to their drawing board in the morning with a simple note from Walt Disney himself: stop throwing the good stuff away. Folks, tonight this stage before us is filled with neatly taped pieces of some of those drawing papers. Some of them had been previously crumpled up and unfortunately thrown away at some point during our educational journey. You see, the traditional education system at times has little use or tolerance for those that do not fit into a neat and tidy mold. Rather than accept the creative passion and strong personalities that the students in front of us tonight offer as a benefit, sometimes that traditional system takes an easier pass by crumpling them up and throwing them away. The existence and inner strength of community high school program is built on a simple premise that each day is a new beginning and a clean slate. Reaching into that trash basket, we have pulled out the crumpled up, torn up treasures, and they are treasures to us. The creative passion, strong personalities, we view them as a benefit in our world, and they will never be a liability. Staff members have a long history of carefully spreading out those crumpled up students as they arrive, taking them and taping them to the drawing board, and making sure that they are challenged famously by Mr. Shook, who has proudly modified an old Michigan football slogan. Michigan team hears, if you stay, you'll be a champion. Mr. Shook reminds our students, if you stay, you will graduate. And tonight, you're going to see the benefit of that challenge. The journey for them individually and collectively has been more difficult than many can even imagine. They have endured, they have matured, and they found inner strength to reach a goal that for many thought would be out of reach. Yet each graduate knows that they were never alone on that journey after they arrived at the doors and the doorstep at community high school. The challenge to this group of graduates, our parents here tonight, and the community is clear. Community High School has earned its rightful place as a viable high school program with the group of students in front of us tonight leading the way. When barriers were placed in front of this group, they promptly tore them down. They have endured terrible comments from some. They've been called lazy. They've been told they lack motivation to participate in any kind of activities, yet they've continued to do that when the opportunities presented themselves. Some question whether dual enrollment participation was beyond the ability of alternative ed students. Yet when offered the opportunity, our students have not only been successful in doing that, but they've done that with straight A averages in the college classroom. When some question whether there was enough rigor in our program to prepare students to be successful, when they had the chance, 50% of the kids in front of you scored a 20 or higher in at least one area on the ACT test. When it was suggested that perhaps community high school was just handing out diplomas, when we were offered the opportunity, 75% of the kids in front of you tonight are going to be entering post-secondary institutions or training, and another 15%, which I'm very proud to say, are going to enter the United States military on our behalf. Now, I'm just a shop teacher, but simple math says that's about 90% of what we have here, and it tells us that the previous goal of just reaching the diploma for community high school students has now been replaced with a new goal of reaching beyond the high school diploma. Walt Disney would undoubtedly be proud to know that at community, our good stuff is never, ever thrown away. I want to share one more thing that I got a poem. I've modified it a little bit. from its 1934 origin. And I actually got, I received this poem from Ray Clemens, if you know Ray C. from Harley-Davidson dealer. It's a poem that originally was called The Man in the Glass by Peter Wimbrough Sr. It certainly gets at the essence of the difficult journey that our graduates have traveled. I have supplanted the word person out of respect for our female graduates. In 1934, it was the man in the glass. So. But it reads something like this. When you get what you want and your struggle for self and the world makes you king or queen for the day, just go to the mirror and look at yourself and see what that person has to say. For it isn't your father, your mother, or friend whose judgment upon you must pass. The person whose verdict counts most in your life is the one staring back in the glass. They're the person to please, never mind all the rest, for they're with you clear to the end, and you've passed your most difficult and dangerous test if the one in the glass is your friend. You may fool the whole world down the pathway of years and get pats on the back as you pass, but your final reward is heartache and tears if you cheated the one in the glass. And as I close tonight, my advice to this group is simple. Don't cheat the one in the glass. Situations are going to come up. It's going to be difficult. Make sure that we know, as we stare back in that glass proudly, that tonight when we look in that glass, it can be a nice big smile. We like that. So good luck to our graduating class, and we'll get moving on with the next portion of our program. One of the traditions associated with the honors portion of the program involves the individual, this is their favorite part, recognition of each graduating student, the presentation of scholarships and awards, and the Senior of the Year award presentation. It is my pleasure now to represent the collective thoughts of staff members at Community High School as I recognize individual student accomplishments and future goals tonight. The graduates will stand, each one individually, and be recognized when their name and information is read. Are you ready? Oh. Some of them are very nervous about what Mr. Walters is going to say tonight, with very good reason. I have cleaned it up a little bit because it is a family show tonight, for some. Joseph Engel. All right. This is a special night for me because Joey Engel's our first one, Lauren Young's our last one in the alphabet today, and both of them are Erwin Schickler kids, which is awful doggone special to me, I gotta tell you. Love all our kids, but those Erwin Schickler kids just always have a special place. Joey has come a long way since we first met in elementary school. As his hair continues to evolve, well, mine hasn't evolved much, it's been different. Joey's journey to a diploma was difficult, without a doubt. What makes Joe special is his unwavering commitment to finish and prove that with hard work and incredible determination, you can truly reach your goals, and he's an inspiration to others as well. Joey is planning on entering the workforce where the qualities that led him to a diploma will certainly provide him the foundation for success. Joe is a great example of how a creative mind, when put to task, can reach their goals. Joey's been able to do that, and we're very proud of him. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Joseph Engel. Sarah Ball. Wow, where do I start? Sarah arrived in Lapeer and landed at Community High School a couple years ago. She immediately made a positive impact with not only her incredible artistic ability, but with her unwavering sense of helpfulness and caring. Sarah is an independent, strong individual that not only understands the importance of working hard, but the critical component of showing others that you care. Staff members comment that Sarah has the ability to bring a smile to the face of everyone, even on the most difficult of days. One of the most helpful students, independent, strong-willed to succeed, and we all agree. Sarah will certainly be missed in the hallways of Community High School as she continues her personal journey with an interest in becoming a speech therapist. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Sarah Ball. They're not nervous yet because we haven't gotten to the good ones yet. Samantha Canoy. I originally planned to have Mr. Shook come up and demonstrate where he feels pain, Samantha, but we won't do that tonight. Samantha arrived at community and immediately found her way to a number of thoughtful encounters with Mr. Walters. That's right. In those early days, Samantha responded to my efforts to help with some tears, a few jeers, and at times a few choice words that may not be appropriate for tonight. But tonight, Samantha's efforts are being rewarded with a high school diploma. Samantha has grown into an outstanding young lady who was there all along. Just had to get there. But she's an outstanding young lady. She's responsible and she's driven. She's continued to be active in the child development program, juggling school work with real work during her entire senior year. Samantha is going to represent us well as she attends Baker College and continues her path towards a career in human services. Staff comments that Samantha demonstrates the power of our program, where she proudly earned the respect of others by her actions along the way. Miss Samantha Canoy. Cammy Carpenter. I wrote this before I even knew where they were seated, and I said, how ironic that Cammy's bio would be found right alongside Samantha's, and they're sitting next to each other. Nice job, McKee. Cammy arrived at Community High School with something to prove, and boy, did she accomplish that. Cammy is an incredibly driven, determined young lady that will be successful without question. If you don't believe that, ask her. She will gladly tell you. The only variable is time. The success is going to be there. Cammy's filled our hallways with laughter, and as was noted by staff, a few jabs at staff along the way, including yours truly. But Cammy has a great personality, has also been active at EdTech. She will attend Mott Community College with a goal of becoming an ultrasound technician. Her passion for children will allow her to rise to the top without a doubt. Staff comments that Cammy's determination is a model for others to aspire to, and I absolutely agree. Miss Cammy Carpenter. Randy Chastain. Yeah, Randy. Randy. There's a few of these in this group tonight. The next of a few characters in this graduating class that, shall we say, required significantly more mentorship by the principal during their time at community. Let's just say that Randy's focus when he arrived at community, I don't think, was necessarily on education. In fact, his arrival was like clockwork on a daily basis, slightly into either second or third hour. Some of my best laughs, I got to tell you, we work on snow days. But when you see John Wilson and I, we see Randy's Dodge truck come in on two wheels about an hour and a half late, and then watching him tear out of there when he realizes that school's been called off, it's just classic. Loved it. But all kidding aside, Randy, you're looking right now at a young man that has developed into just a fine, outstanding, hardworking young man that worked very, very hard. No one's going to tell this guy that's standing before us how hard it is to get to the diploma. He's done it. He's met his requirements to graduate, some would say, and privately he shared with me mainly to get McKee off his back. I don't know anything about that. But staff comments, Randy developed into a respected individual in his time at community where he realized the importance of school and how true that is. Randy has plans on joining the military and representing us and our country. Word to the wise, Randy. Word to the wise, revelry comes a lot earlier than school starts every day. Good luck, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Randy Chastain. Zach Dinsmore. We discussed this section last night during swing out, and again tonight outside before we came in. Well, we didn't get far before encountering another young man that benefited from a little guidance from Mr. Walters, and I know mom's out there somewhere. Stacy will agree with that. Where do I start? There's a special bond that staff has with all of our students at community. Zach is a young man that challenged every one of us, including myself, at times. And when you heard me talk a little bit about those passionate, creative, independent people that don't necessarily fit that traditional mold, sometimes they're challenging even in the alternative setting, and that's okay. We had to get to a happy medium, and we got there. His arrival as a rather, and he doesn't mind me saying this, immature adolescent male caused a number of us to question whether he was going to make it. Yet all along, we knew he had the ability to do just that. We just had the hope, and it was mentioned by staff, he had the ability to spend a little less time socializing with a certain other female student to get to class on time. Not mentioning any names. All kidding aside again, Zach matured and grew into a young man that has demonstrated not only his abilities as a student, but those as a quality person as well. Staff comments that Zach reached a point where hard work replaced avoidance and his abilities finally reached the surface. Zach plans on attending Mott Community College, where he'll become an electrician. In fact, he's already started working for a local company here in Lapeer to start that training path. Zach was able to persevere and achieve his goals, and his reward is a diploma that he is about to receive tonight. Best of luck, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Zach Dinsmore. Good ball. All right, we haven't got to the T's yet. Sorry, in the back. Raynell Flansburg. Is that a beautiful smile or what? I got to tell you, Raynell is, she's just an outstanding young lady that has continued to bring a smile to the faces of every person she encounters. It is, when you talk about someone who has a contagious personality and smile, Raynell is that person. She has the special ability to maintain her poise under pressure, and she has earned the respect of all the staff members and her peers along the way. Raynell has been active in the cosmetology program through EdTech. She even took on the difficult task of challenge of cutting Mr. Shook's hair at times. If you know Mr. Shook and his hair, they don't like to part. She still hasn't answered the challenge that I always give her, that is there anything that you can do with this? So hopefully now that she's a graduate, she can. You see the smile, she always smiles, so. Raynell, again, we cannot say enough. She has brought with her every single day, good, bad, indifferent, every day, that absolute beautiful smile and personality that is going to be impossible to replace. Raynell is going to attend Paul Mitchell as she obviously continues her journey toward cosmetology and expanding that training, and we are absolutely positive that she will do a great job. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Raynell Flansburg. Jacob Hartwell. Oh, Jake, don't let this guy fool you. He may be one of the most daring people you will ever meet, or crazy one. This guy, imagine my surprise the first time I happened upon a game of hacky sack, where Jake said, "Hey, Walters, you want to play?" Now, there's a lot of images one may have of the principal of the building, but unleashing my cat-like reflexes upon their group with a dazzling display of agility may not be one of them. Jake is some kind of player, I'll tell you what. I learned an awful lot. But the best of which apparently must always have a hat on. Not always straight, of course. Tonight, I told him, you look a lot better with this hat on than you do that on you wear all the time. As they go through. And apparently, I didn't know this, I need to play more hacky sack, but apparently it leads to extensive weight loss because the backside of him, he can't seem to keep his pants up at EdTech, so. Sorry. That's one advantage I could have. I need to play more hacky. My wife's out there going, teach him how to play hacky sack, will you, Jake? Again, I'll tell you what, this young man is driven. A young man, and I've been doing this a long time, and this is a young man that when you put a challenge in front of him, that challenge is going to be met, period. It's non-negotiable, and that's what's going to carry this young man through his career that's going to carry him as an individual. He is not going to give up. He is not going to look for an easy way out. And again, he has a bright future ahead of him after working extremely hard to get to this point. He's already been accepted at Lincoln Tech, where he will study collision repair, and we are absolutely certain, staff agrees, that he will be successful in whatever he attempts. Mr. Jacob Hartwell. He probably has a hacky sack in his pocket right now.
Probably does.
There you go. I knew it. I don't know. I always told him, I said, man, if I ever hit the ground, it's going to take the whole doggone group of you to get me upright again. It's like Humpty Dumpty, you know. I don't know. They were very kind to me anyway. Aaron Hembry. All right. Aaron arrived at Community High School, and he brought with him an interesting approach to things, to say the least, in a good way. Whether it was engaging in a healthy debate in class, which he was widely known for, or finding numerous ways to, and I put this in quotation, legally leave campus without permission, Aaron fit right in. He drives a Jeep, folks. My window's right in the very front of the building. There's 15 student drivers. Even with poor eyesight, I can find that. Aaron fit right in. Again, if he could find a way to sneak in without me seeing him, he'd be good to go. But seriously, Aaron did an outstanding job. And as many of our students, and you're going to hear the things, it's about work ethic. And the one thing with Aaron is that when he came in, he understood what that path is. When we do our intake interviews, and I know there's a lot of parents out there that have sat through those, or grandparents with me particularly, we talk about a roadmap to a diploma. It's non-negotiable. You're going to get there. The only variables are what you make of them. And Aaron was the young man right away that understood that. He understood what he needed to do. And when the challenge was in front of him, he made sure that he did that. At the same time, acclimating himself group as well. Staff comments that Aaron worked very, very hard to reach his goal of graduating. He's participated in ed tech programming. He'll continue his interest in human services as a student at Ferris State University. We are very confident Aaron will be successful at whatever he attempts. And of course, we wish him the best of luck along the way. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Aaron Hembry. Marcus McGlone. I talk about talented, there is a level of artistic ability within this young man that is, although we have a number of very special students in front of us, Marcus, I will say, is one of the most talented artists I've ever encountered in my career as an educator. His creative mind is unparalleled, and his potential is absolutely limitless. If you ever get a chance to sit down with this young man, he will challenge you intellectually. He's just a fine young man. Marcus brought to Community an outstanding personality and approach to his day-to-day. If it weren't for that weird connection to Joe Pastore and Ryan Dudley, he'd actually be somewhat normal compared to the rest of us. Sorry if Joe or Ryan are here. No, not really. Staff comments that Marcus handles himself with a calm determination that will lead to success in the future. We say calm determination. Marcus handled himself in a mature manner every single day. That is very difficult. For those of you that understand the creative mind, its rules and parameters don't fit well within the creative mind. Marcus has handled that exceptionally well, which is a tribute to him. The sky is truly the limit for Marcus, as we wish him the best of luck in his journey. We have already mentioned he's an incredible talented artist who fit in our program from day one. He always had a smile on his face, a positive attitude that did not go unnoticed by staff. Marcus is already attending Mott Community College, where he will continue his education. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Marcus McGlone. Francesca McKelvey. It's one of the advantages of doing this gig is that you actually get to call them by their nicknames so parents can't yell at you. Frankie. This is Frankie. Ma'am, were we glad that you chose us to end your high school career. You're an outstanding young lady and a phenomenal artist that has endured and emerged as a success. We're very, very proud of you. You brought a sense of reality to your peers, and you possess an incredible ability to relate to everyone. Let me tell you, we're in a society sometimes where we get locked into our own things. This young lady can have a conversation and can relate to the day-to-day issues that anyone's going through and help. She's there. She has that caring sense about her. You'll be a success in life. I frantically myself read through the yearbook as I was certain you would bequeath to an underclassman your uncanny ability to stroll into the teacher's lounge for a cup of coffee every morning. In fact, one staff member commented that Frankie is a voracious reader, Mr. O'Brien, fancy words, as well as a philosopher. Oh, philosophical. She always had a book in one hand and a cup of coffee in the other, ready to discuss her reading. Frankie's going to continue her studies in the pursuit of medical training and occupational therapist assistant. Don't ever change, Frankie. You're fantastic the way you are. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Francesca McKelvey. Jesse Moore. That's right. Jesse. How fitting. First off, I have one word, wardrobe, baby. That guy, I'm telling you. Jesse has the most complete wardrobe of thought-provoking shirts I have ever seen. I'm not kidding. Although the Batman shirt is a crowd pleaser, nothing tops the grandpa shirt that he was wearing yesterday, Jesse. What is that? Grandpa does the spoiling? Jesse has just an unbelievable... If you know, obviously, with Jesse, the creative mind that this young man has is just, again, it's limitless. A fine young man. That's a classic for sure. Jesse's an incredibly talented young man. He has fit in perfectly at community high school. He's earned the respect of his classmates. He's earned the respect of his teachers in his time with us. He is a warm, friendly, hardworking, determined young man. He's been at school, I think, every day, even after the seniors have left. Finishing classes for McKee, probably. It's a common theme, no. But Jesse's definitely a young man that others can rely upon to be a friend, and if we could all share that quality, we'd be a much better place for sure. But we're very confident that Jesse will make the same impact beyond community as he enters the workforce as that he did when he was a student there. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jesse Moore. Ashley Morey. I remember Ashley as she sat in my office after Mr. Hobolth had to call to lobby for her enrollment mid-year. Senior year, that's a tough thing to do. Usually when he calls me with an offer, if you know Mr. Hobolth, and I love Mr. Hobolth, but usually when he tells me there's an offer it's too good for me to pass up, I get a little nervous. In this case, the offer was beyond what any of us could imagine. Ashley joined us late in her senior year at a point where we literally became, for her final opportunity to make it to tonight. But again, we had a discussion, and it was upon her to do a ton of work to be able to get here. With turmoil and drama getting in the way of her success, Ashley needed a change. I think it's safe to say that had she not followed through and advocated for herself, to become enrolled as a student at community, I'm not sure she would be receiving that diploma tonight. Her determination and incredible personality drove her actions towards being successful. Those are qualities that will serve her well as she continues her path to Mott Community College, where she will study to become an orthopedic technician. On behalf of the staff at community, I want to say thank you for giving us a chance to be part of your success, Ashley. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Ashley Morey. Catherine Mullenix. I promised I'd be good, Mom, but I have to call her Kitty. Sorry. Kitty's first steps at community were rather difficult, shall we say. In fact, She had not the smiling face in my direction during some of our meetings, but rather a distinct glare at me from time to time during our frequent discussions. But during that rough exterior of a younger individual, the version of Kitty emerged an incredibly talented artist and even more incredible person. Kitty's one of the very few students that I've encountered that steps up to their past actions and uses them to motivate her and use that experience to positively impact others. That is a very difficult thing to do. If you have conflict with people, you work beyond that. Sometimes you say, I'm glad that's done, and you don't worry about it anymore. Kitty went back within herself, came into me this year right off the bat and said, you know what, I'm going to make this right because this is my senior year and I'm going to make sure that I do that. And she did that, and that is absolutely incredibly difficult to do and something that has earned my respect and everyone else's. She definitely matured the most, became an influence to others, a good role model for fellow students to follow, as well as her sibling who joined us. We're very proud of the individual you've become, and we are confident that Kitty will demonstrate the same determination as she attends Baker College to become a surgical technician. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Catherine Mullinex. Before I get to the next one, there's no Mott Community College administrators present, are there? Very good. Oh, I'll preface my comments with an apology. No. Rachel Palmer. Rachel knows what I'm going to say. I'll be good, I promise. Rachel joined us for her senior year, and I am sure with some level of hesitation and anxiety. We are so glad Rachel gave us an opportunity to be part of her success. Rachel is an incredible student, and when I say incredible, I'm saying incredible to the tune of a 25 composite on the ACT, incredible. She has demonstrated a will to succeed in every single class experience. She's a very talented writer who has been given the gift of voice. Her ability to describe what she sees through the written word is truly remarkable. When staff members come and hand me written work from students and say, you have to read this, usually that's a good thing. And when we say that and that's come from the staff, her words come alive. Rachel gets the award for contributing to one of the very, very few times that Mr. Walters has been angry. That doesn't happen very often, believe it or not, for some of you in the back row. They may argue that. But that occurred because we were trying to enroll for dual enrollment, and unfortunately, the post-secondary group refused to enroll her based on what they felt was too low a grade point average overall. Needless to say, a little discussion on my part in advocating while Rachel was in the room with me. Not only was she enrolled, but she completed her English Lit class with flying colors, something we expected would happen. Part of our challenge, and Rachel's helping us with that, is that grade point average has nothing to do with ability. It's about the ability and the challenges they've gone through before they got here. You're looking at a young lady that I'm not worried about what her grade point average is, and I think I shared that, and I'll share it publicly tonight. It's about her ability, and that's what we're interested in. Rachel's made community her final stop in her high school journey, and we are very appreciative as a staff that she did. Rachel will continue to attend Mott, so she wasn't scarred too bad, where she will study health services in the area of medical tech. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Rachel Palmer. Chaz Pridemore. Boy, I knew that was coming. Hey, Chaz. Chaz arrived at Community High School. He doesn't know this, but before he arrived, I got a phone call from a very dear old colleague of mine from West High School who said, you're going to love this guy. You better let him in or I'm going to come over. And she did. Celeste Walk did that. Chaz arrived during his senior year, and he brought with him a warm, determined approach to finishing school. This is one of the nicest young men you're going to meet, I guarantee you. Chaz is just a phenomenal young man. He immediately established friendships, which is difficult to do. And he earned the respect of both his peers and staff members for a quiet approach and effort on a daily basis. Chaz completed the RVR program at EdTech and has an interest in entering the workforce as soon as he can. We are extremely confident that Chaz has all the characteristics to be an outstanding member of our society, and we know he's going to create happiness and success along the way. I cannot say enough nice things about this young man. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure, Chaz Pridemore. Laura Ruffner. I am not verbose, long-winded, as Mrs. Ridenour would sometimes say. I have 30 of these to go through tonight, which is an outstanding senior class, and we're not gonna rush through them. Laura, well, where do we start with Laura Ruffner? Boy, where do we start? Laura possesses a rare blend of high academic ability and an absolute genuine compassion for others. Laura's just an outstanding young lady. She's been an active member in a number of school activities in her time and community, has continued to earn the respect of every single person that she comes into contact with. That is rare. It is rare for a student to have that ability to immediately earn the respect of every person that she encounters, and that she's done that with her peers and others. She's been very active and successful in completing the Horticulture Agri-Science program at EdTech, and is probably partly responsible for these beautiful flowers of some sort, probably, that are here tonight from that. She finished her high school career number 2 in her graduating class, where she was honored by TV5's Brightest and Best, as well as being named honorable mention to the All-Lapeer County academic team. Laura is going to continue her educational journey at Mott Community College, where she's interested in expanding upon her study in horticulture. She's also, you will not be surprised, an outstanding artist. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Laura Ruffner. Mason Rule. Mason. Man, I remember the first time I saw Mason in my office. I think we would agree that he wanted to be anywhere but sitting at that campus at community high school. And that's not uncommon. Sometimes students go, man, I want to be anywhere but here, until they start to look at those things. He was hesitant at first, as a number are, but he gave us a chance. And I can speak for the entire staff when I say that, man, we are thankful that day that Mason gave us a chance to be part of his success. He has been an active member in all of our leadership activities at Community High School, including membership on the Omni Forum, which is a collaboration between East, West, and community. He has represented community in a number of events. He's volunteered his time within the community as well. Mason has grown before us, entering with that just a little bit of hesitation and exiting with a sense of both accomplishment and determination that has been very well earned. Mason loves music as well as reading. Many of the conversations he had with staff centered around music, as well as the books that he was reading or would currently involved in. Mason was quiet and unassuming, yet when asked, he always provided a poignant answer during discussions about literature. You will not be surprised that Mason indicates he wants to continue his educational journey in the hopes of becoming an English teacher, where we can only hope that he'll have the opportunity to impact students that are also hesitant about joining the program, as he has been impacted in his time with us. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mason Rule. Cody Rumble. The last thing the building principal wants on commencement night is a phone call from one of your students saying, I'm stuck in traffic at 34 Mile. I may be a little late. That's right. So we're glad Cody made it safely. We're sure he didn't fracture any speed limit laws in his attempt to get here on time. Well, it was quite honestly a contest between Cody and Randy to see who could keep Deputy Hill the busiest in the parking lot with vehicle issues. Cardboard is not a proper substitute for a back window, apparently. Cody's one of the few students that I have actually, and I'm going to get in trouble for this because my boss is here, I've actually granted permission to leave campus to field dress a deer that he hit on the way to school. This young man could sell ice to an Eskimo. We'll get to that later with Mr. Melkerson. But I'll tell you, the best part was we had a parade of students before he could take the doggone deer out of there. He had to make sure everybody came out to look at the deer and the damage to the truck. But Cody's path to a diploma was not easy, nor enjoyable at times. We know that. But Cody will forever have the respect of staff members for his continued positive and helpful attitude and approach to life. Although a stumble or two found its way to Cody's path, every single time this kid jumped right back up, dusted himself off, and he started forward again every time. And that's the essence of what you're going to see with all of our students. But Cody, every single time, he was going to do that. He was a dedicated young man who grew up while at our school. He went from a student who hated to read, but changed his mind when he found out that books are a great escape. Whether it was reading, discussing his reading, or knocking out someone's teeth accidentally during a floor hockey game, Cody always tried his best. That did happen. We're very proud of what he's become. Cody was honored by his peers as being voted as the one of the worst vehicles, which he and I to this day believe was rigged by his classmates John Tapp and Randy Chastain, who seemed to have a belief that only Dodge full-size pickups actually qualify as trucks. Cody will be trading in his work boots for a pair of military boots as he enters the service in defense of our country. That's right. This is an outstanding young man. Best of luck, Cody. Make us proud. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Cody Rumble. I forgot to mention he's a little on the shy side. Shostin Svinarich. Hi, Shostin. Shostin's still mad at me. We're going to get to that. The fact that Shostin has survived being friends with a handful of our more colorful members in the back row is simply amazing in and of itself. If it weren't for her, I don't know if they would be here. I'm just saying. Always with a smile, beautiful smile, and a genuine caring for others, Shostin handled even the most difficult situations with ease and a comfortable pair of boots of her own. That's right. From time to time, Mr. Walters will, shall we say, encourage particular other members of the graduating class to maybe stay on course. While Shostin heard that a number of times when I was saying that to other members that will remain nameless, it was the day that I innocently stated to Shostin that perhaps she was drifting away from us as of late that got a reaction, and boy, did it get a reaction. Even though she still may be a little bit upset with me, it's within that reaction that really brings to the surface the essence of this young lady. She has determination. She's strong-willed. That's exactly what you need to survive in this difficult world today. And that's the reaction that we want to see. And I don't think she's mad at me anymore. I hope not. Strong-willed, and she's ready to meet any challenge in the world ahead of her that's going to offer. And we all agree as a staff that Shostin will do just fine in doing that. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure, Shostin Svinarich. Here we go. John Tapp. Thank goodness there is a self-imposed time limit to ceremonies like this. Or I have a file cabinet full of John Tapp stories that could literally take all night to explain to you. Where do we start? How about yesterday at rehearsal when John decided the use of the steps to exit the stage was optional? A little reminder from Mr. Walters. There were some parents and grandparents here, I apologize, but they heard me say there are two ways graduates cross the stage. Safe to say one of them is a preferred method under their own power. For the record, John Tapp is the only person I have met that can single-handedly create an international incident by simply attempting to empty pop cans from a box to a bag. Everything goes to heck in the same day. One day. He's also the only student that has ever asked me permission to go to his vehicle to get a suture kit that he keeps in his truck to tend to an injury that he had. Gotta love John. This kid, he will survive. You've heard the old song, this guy will survive. His efforts to bequeath to assorted underclassmen his unbelievable ability to increase Mrs. McKee's blood pressure by 50 points at any given moment was appropriately caught by me and not put in the yearbook. Nice try, John. Of course, we're kidding. John, his path has been rather unique, but this is a great young man. And I'm going to tell you, this guy that's standing up, many of the students have the same story, similar stories. But I'm going to tell you, John Tapp had every reason. There were 100 reasons that kid had to quit. And we only asked him to find the one reason to get to the finish line. Just one, John, can you get there? And you know what? This kid has sat in seventh hour. He sat in summer school dealing with me. It's bad enough he got to deal with me all year. He sat with me from summer school beyond the regular classes. This kid knows what it takes to do, to work hard, to achieve something. And that has earned all of our respect, no question about it. He's not only worked extremely hard with the support of not only his staff, but his family, who's been incredible to help him get to the finish line. That, and I hear from one of our staff members, bribes of donuts to teachers. Now, you never brought me any donuts, John. Jeez. John plans to enter the military, where the staff agrees that we will sleep much better knowing that he is defending us. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. John Tapp. Right. You can sit down now, John. You can tell John's a little nervous about that encounter with Mr. Walters yesterday, too. That's good. Aaron Thornsberry. Yeah. I'll tell you, if you find anyone that has a bigger heart than this kid, I'd like to meet him. This Aaron Thornsberry is a phenomenal young man. He has a genuine sense of personable approach that you rarely see in young people today. He has continued to steadily work towards earning his diploma, which has been his target from the start. Aaron's not only been very active in leadership in our building as a respected member of among his peers, but he's also included serving on Omni Council and volunteering in the community along the way. He's found time to complete his collision repair program at EdTech, and he plans on continuing his training in the area of automotive painting. He also proudly holds the deadlift record at Community High School, a feat that will not easily be broken anytime soon. How much was it? 405. 405 pounds. Our staff agrees that whatever Aaron chooses to do, he's going to do it with the same determination, quality approach, and huge heart that we've come to appreciate at Community High School. This is, again, an outstanding young man. Best of luck, Aaron. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Aaron Thornsberry. Julian Tyndale. I don't think I've ever seen me and Julio down by the schoolyard. For the last time, Julio. For me, anyway. This is one special cat, old Julio, let me tell you. I've got a little history of this family dating way back to when I arrived in this district about 20 years ago. What a great family that is. I can't say enough about that. When some would have just, Julian's path to community came at the hands of a bad decision, no doubt about it. Many of his classmates have had the same starting point. When some would have just chalked it up to being part of an image of your typical bad kid, Julian, he decided he had something to prove from minute one. This, with the support of a great family, staff members of the community, this young man embarked upon a journey that was going to lead to a high school diploma on time and at a high level. He was not going to be satisfied with anything else. Although it's not common to discuss struggles with learning individual students have, I'm going to break from that a little bit tonight because I'm sure it's okay because it's about what we're going to talk about tonight. And that is I want to let you know that Julian has been classified as having a learning disability. He never let that be an excuse of why he couldn't learn. He never used that as a crutch. He needed that assistance when he needed it, but he never took the opportunity to say, I'm going to just kind of take it easy today. He wanted to make an effort to do the things that he needed to do. And while some maybe settle into habits of enabling, Julian stepped beyond that disability, and he took steps to prove he could be successful without special support or classrooms. With the help and vision of Mr. Grover, and I want to mention that, I very rarely do that, Julian set the standard of how services should be provided, and he broke a glass ceiling that has typically restricted students from achieving the success that this young man has achieved. Julian finished his high school career as the top student in the class of 2013, earning a grade point average. That's right. And we make it clear to everyone, we don't teach fundamental classes at community. We don't teach special ed classes. We teach full, traditional, educational, core classes. He's also focused on becoming a welder, fabricator, completing a program in ed tech over the past 2 years. He was invited to represent Community High School at the Channel 7 Brightest and Best, Channel 5 Brightest and Best events, and was named honorable mention all Lapeer County academic team. He was also honored by his classmates as being named prom king. He is most widely recognized as an incredible dancer, donning the Texas Chainsaw Massacre outfit and mask, jumping from behind the very slight frame of Mr. Walters to dance upon a table in Community High's unique version of the Harlem Shake during lunch this spring. If you haven't seen it, you need to take a look at that. His crazy antics always brought bewilderment as well as smiles to his teachers' faces. And Mrs. Wagner fondly recalled that Julian proudly announced that Uncrustables, thank you, Joyce, you're here. If you don't know what those are the peanut butter and jelly sandwiches that don't have any, you know, are really the only reason I come to school in the morning. That and art class. Always playing the angle, Julio. Julian, we know, sometimes had more paint on his face than actually on his art projects. But the future is both bright and endless for Julian. Thanks for providing an opportunity to prove our partner school across town wrong, Julian. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Julian Tyndale. Kimberly Vanderford. It is very rare, not too rare, that I'm threatened. It's rare that I'm threatened by female graduates. Kim said, if you pronounce my name Vanderford one more time, I'm going to slap you in front of everybody. So I did it right today. I apologize, Mom and Sis. Kim arrived at community with a bit of a complex. Not sure if this was the right place for her. In fact, it absolutely was the right place for her to develop into the wonderful young lady that she's become. That is not easy. That is not to say that there were not a few bumpy spots along the way. We wouldn't be where we are if that was the case. Memorization of a parent's phone number, cell phone number, is typically a sign of that. I can probably erase that now. What Kim came to realize was that she not only had a supportive family outside of school, but inside as well. She's a very good student that continued to demonstrate proficiency in the classroom while always finding the time to squeeze in some, shall we say, socialization time. Kim apparently enjoys riding in Jeeps, found this, especially if they are driven by an unnamed male student during lunch en route to a local eatery prior to sneaking out to Ed Tech. For some reason, I also had Kathy Amboy's number memorized as well. All kidding aside, Miss Kim, as the early childhood program at Ed Tech calls her, was active in childhood development training, plans to continue her educational journey at Mott, with the goal of entering the education field. We're very pleased to announce, best of luck, Miss Kimberly Vanderford. Dominic Verisco. Dominic, I tell you, this guy, he's an outstanding young man. It's been an absolute wonderful addition to Community High program. Dominic arrived to us from out of state and immediately gained the respect of staff members with his determined approach and effort in class. He is a very studious young man that also understands the importance of hard work and setting goals for himself. Imagine my pride when I'm at my daughter, a daughter's event at Mayfield Elementary, and this young man is part of our evening cleaning crew working in addition to going to school. And he's being respectful to young people in that building and the students and parents. It just talks to this man, this young man's work ethic and what he's about. He's continued to develop friendships that will last a lifetime for him and others. I can recall meeting with Dominic and his family, and I know you're out there during the intake interview, where he had attempted to enroll in one of our the schools here in Lapeer as he came here. And he was from what was classified as a magnet type alternative school. So they told him he had to enroll at community. And it became very, very obvious that he had the ability to be successful if he chose to go to East or West. And I'll never forget Dominic saying, absolutely not, I'm going to stay right here. I'm going to enroll. Man, are we absolutely, I speak for the entire staff when I say we've enjoyed every moment that we've been able to spend with Dominic. Mr. O'Brien described Dominic as a quiet and unassuming man who has an adventurous soul. He loves adventure novels with, you know who your favorite author is, Louis L'Amour. Probably said that wrong. Bill's going to correct me. He said, I always enjoyed our discussion surrounding these Louis L'Amour adventure novels, and he will be missed. We must read not only for what we read, but for what it makes us think. He is truly an outstanding young man that will be successful in whatever he attempts, which for him will begin as a member of the United States Coast Guard. Even though the whiteboard in Ms. McKee's office Dominic has a sense of humor. When they write where they're going, he's going to the Coast Guard. He wrote Harvard next to his name. I think he could do it. I know he could do it. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dominic Verisco. Chelsea Wilson. Chelsea's going, you better not. Chelsea arrived mid-year. And immediately, from out of state, immediately jumped right into our mix of community. To say that Chelsea is a shy young lady is not exactly accurate, as it became fairly obvious right away that she has the gift of gab in addition to being an outstanding student. It's always difficult for our out-of-state students, particularly seniors, to meet the requirements to graduate. Chelsea was determined to finish and graduate this year, and she put her mind to doing just that. That is not an easy task when you come in your senior year. We are very, very pleased that she chose community high school to conclude her high school career, and we're very confident that her academic abilities will be enhanced by her gift of gab and extensive socialization skills in finding success beyond Lapeer Community High School. Chelsea worked extremely hard. We're very, very proud of the work that you did to finish up. Best of luck from all of the staff. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Chelsea Wilson. Ken Wood. Kenneth Wood. Now, you may have noticed that Mr. Walters was slightly delayed at arriving here tonight. I've had students cut it close, but I'm going to be honest with you. About 3 hours before we arrived here tonight, Ken finished his last credit to graduate. That's right. You know you're in trouble when you got to rely on the principal. He's your last friend in the world to get this done. So Ken was able to do that. Ken, this is an outstanding young man. And he obviously likes to live life a little on the edge, a little too close to the edge for my liking, but a thrill seeker of sorts that did not appear nervous in the least today that he needed to finish that class to graduate. In fact, I love it. Instead of coming in, you know, you think on the last day if you had to do that, you'd buckle down and lock yourself in that doggone room and finish that class. No, Ken, he's out and about. He's visiting. He's walking through. This guy's got ice in his veins, I'm telling you. But thank goodness he finished. As our staff agrees that this young man, Ken's been an absolute delight to have as a student at Community High School. He's consistently put forth effort, and he has a personality that absolutely fit perfectly in the school. Ken's been active in ed tech programming. He has an interest in continuing his training in the workforce as an auto mechanic. We are extremely confident that Ken will be successful and represent both himself and the program well in whatever he attempts. With a huge sigh of relief, Mr. Ken Wood. Yeah. Samantha Williams. Wow. If you were to open a dictionary and look at the word eloquent, you would see a picture of Samantha Williams. Her quiet demeanor brought forward a grace that defines her as a person. Samantha brings relevance to the argument that students at community high school are in search more for a comfortable environment for learning than they are escaping issues or other inaccurate perceptions that are out there. This is an outstanding example of what we are. Samantha is a strong, determined, successful young lady that continues to approach things with a positive, forward approach that will certainly assist her as she moves on to her next success. Samantha's been involved in the cosmetology program through EdTech, has been accepted at Baker College, where she will study psychology in the human service area. Samantha was number 3 in the class of 2013 and was named honorable mention all Lapeer County academic team. Samantha was also honored by her peers as being voted prom queen for 2013. Best of luck, Samantha, Miss Samantha Williams. Josh Yaks, we've reached the Y's. Yeah. Josh arrived to us, immediately found his way into the community high school family. From day one, he's put forth the effort needed to be successful as a student while displaying a positive attitude and demeanor on a daily basis. Josh has been very active in EdTech programming and actually completed an internship at our year-round elementary school at Turrell during his senior year as part of his child development program at EdTech. Speaks to volumes of his impact on students. He will continue on the path of working with early childhood education in the future as well. Rumor has it Josh is quite the musical artist. Ironically, so am I. When I asked if I could join him on the stage, Josh politely indicated, I'm not sure that would work out, Walters. I think I'll take his word for it. Kidding, of course. Staff shared Josh has grown into an outstanding young man. He's fully taken advantage of his time at community high school, and we're extremely fortunate that he has impacted us as well. Best of luck to you and your journey to impact the youth of tomorrow, Josh. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Josh Yaks. Last one, Lauren Young. Lauren is an outstanding and accomplished young lady. Now, our students know that I have very strong feelings. I talked about that before, but there's always a very special bond with our Irwin Schickler kids like Lauren. Her path to graduation was blocked with a number of issues that were out of her control. She didn't allow those barriers to get in the way of her unwavering determination to be successful. And successful she has been. Lauren's been very active in the EdTech programming, where she has completed and earned statewide recognition for her efforts. Beyond that, Lauren's been dual enrolled during her entire senior year, completing college level coursework and accomplishing those with flying colors. She has a passion for learning and a greater passion for animals, which fuels her future plans of transferring from Mott Community College to Michigan State, where she plans and has visions and a goal of studying to become a veterinarian. Staff comments, that's right. Staff comments that you will not find a more caring individual in any school than Miss Lauren Young. Yeah. Oh, it wasn't that bad. All right, whew, I'm exhausted. Not really. Next part of our show is the scholarship and awards, and it gives me great pleasure to introduce Mrs. McKee, who will handle the presentation with help from our visitors and esteemed guest for scholarships and award. Please join me in welcoming Mrs. McKee.
Good evening. Oh, I'll have to move this down a little. Okay, tonight is part of our graduation ceremony. We are honored to be presenting awards and scholarships that our seniors will be receiving. Community organizations and area schools honor Lapeer Community High School by providing scholarships to some of our outstanding seniors who plan on continuing their education. As Mr. Walters stated early, nearly 75% of this graduating class plans on continuing pursuing higher education. The potential for scholarship has encouraged many of our students to further their education and is truly appreciated by Lapeer Community High School students, staff, and parents. When your name is called, please come forward to receive your award. The first award will be presented by Mr. Walters.
Oh, do you have it on there? Okay. Probably heard enough of me already. It is my honor tonight. I've been fortunate enough to spend time with the Lapeer Alumni Association, and they did not have a representative to present tonight, so I am proudly stepping in to do that. The Alumni Association has a competitive scholarship process where students apply, and they have a committee that goes through these applications, and they select a recipient. And the recipient of the Lapeer Alumni Scholarship for 2013 in the amount of $1,000 is Mr. Julian Tyndale. As part of the alumni scholarship, they have a banquet in July where Julian and myself will attend, and family, where they have an award ceremony because they obviously have awards for Lapeer East, Lapeer West, and Community High School. So.
Thank you. The Kiwanis organization has generously provided a scholarship to a Lapeer Community High School student for the past 7 years. This scholarship will be explained and presented by Ms. Julie Karras.
The Kiwanis Club, our philosophy is to try to change the world one child at a time. We go through the applications and select who we feel share our philosophy. It is an honor to share in tonight's ceremony. Thank you. I am here to present the Kiwanis Scholarship, and the first certificate of achievement goes to Rachel Palmer. And we have another scholarship, $5,000 scholarship, that goes to Catherine
Mullenix.
There we go.
I'm sorry. It's okay. Thank you.
And thank you, and congratulations to all the students up there.
Thank you very much. Usually we get, Kiwanis gives one scholarship, and this year we're very lucky that they awarded two scholarships, so that's great. Okay. The next scholarship is the Lapeer Education Association Scholarship. Union dues from teaching staff of Lapeer Community Schools funds this scholarship, and it is my pleasure to award the $500 scholarship to a student. She's been with us for 2 years, and she is one of our top seniors. Get it out. Number two, as a matter of fact, this award goes to Laura Ruffner. Don't be nervous. Okay. Okay. The Lapeer Community Scholarship was originally funded by total staff campaign and contributions And these contributions continue to support this the worthy recognition of our students. This scholarship has been awarded to Lapeer community students for 28 years. The Loan Board recently increased the scholarship to $1,000. We're proud to present this scholarship to one of our top seniors. She participated in state competition where she placed second in veterinary assistance. In addition, she earned 10 college credits through dual enrollment this year alone, which is wonderful. We expect great things from her. This scholarship goes to Lauren Young. Hit this thing. Okay, the next scholarship is the Baker College Alternative Education Scholarship, and it will be presented and explained by Kara Lum from Baker College in Flint.
Thank you for the opportunity to be here this evening. Baker College has worked closely with the Clear Community Schools for many years, and it is such a pleasure to present this year's scholarship. Before I do, I'd like to take a second to congratulate all the graduates here tonight. I know that it has taken a lot of hard work and dedication to get this far. This year's scholarship recipients have demonstrated high achievement, ambition, and drive to succeed. I know that by getting the right skills and training, you'll be successful. I will be awarding two alternative scholarships this evening. The scholarship is worth half tuition for 2 years. Please help in congratulating the scholarship recipients. And would you please step forward to receive your award, Samantha Williams. And Samantha Canoy. Once again, thank you for the opportunity, and I wish you all the best of luck.
Mott Community College has also been a very long-time supporter of Lapeer Community High School. The Mott Community College Trustee Leadership Scholarship will be presented and explained by Dolores Sharp from Mott Community College in Flint.
Good evening, and Mr. Walters, no hard feelings. In fact, after this ceremony, I'll be happy to give you my card. If it ever happens again, come straight to me. I'll take care of it for you. Good evening, and thank you for the opportunity to be here. You know, my community college has been providing a quality education to the people of Genesee County and its surrounding communities for over 90 years, and has been recognized by the Aspen Institute as one of the top 10 community colleges in the country. My community college offers more than 100 different career programs and provides the first 2 years of instruction for virtually any four-year course of study at any four-year university in the state. On behalf of Mott Community College, I am proud to present the Trustee Leadership Scholarship. This scholarship is an award reserved for students who have proven to be the best and the brightest and who are held in high regard by their teachers and counselors. It provides up to 2 full years of tuition and fees for the recipient and is worth over $8,000. With this year's recipient of the Mott Community College Trustee Leadership Scholarship, please join me, Julian Tyndale. You know, I have to say real quickly that I was really, really appreciated hearing all the student bios, and I think Julian will be a great benefit to the whatever community he ends up in.
I'm almost ready for you. Two more students I want to recognize real quickly, if you just stand at your seat. Mason Rule He received high honors in the culinary arts program this year. He received an award earlier at EdTech when they did their performance. But Mason, you want to stand up? Just stand there. Okay. Okay. Mason received the high honors, and that's a really great thing. There's not a lot of the students that are able to get that, so congratulations. And also would Josh Hartwell stand up, please? I don't know. Jacob, see, I'm looking at you, and I'm Jacob Hartwell, stand up. Jacob is going to Lapeer, Lincoln Tech. I'm messed up tonight. Lincoln Tech. In Indianapolis, I know where it is, and he is going to be receiving a $1,000 scholarship to attend there. I don't have it here, but I know he's getting it. So now, thank you. And the final award of the evening will be presented by Mr. Bill O'Brien.
Every year, the staff at Lapeer Community High School nominates and elects the Senior of the Year. It gives me great pleasure to announce Ms. Sam Williams as Senior of the Year.
Right. Now to the good stuff, right? The remaining portion of our ceremony tonight will involve the commencement of our student graduates. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Matt Wandry, the Superintendent of Schools, for comments and introduction of Lapeer Community Schools Board of Education members.
Thank you very much. This time I'd like to individually introduce the members of our Board of Education joining us this evening. Firstly, our President, Mr. Mike Keller. Vice President, Mr. Gary Oyster. Trustee, Mr. Jonathan Nugent. Trustee, Mrs. Denise Becker. Trustee, Mrs. Wendy Byard. And Trustee Mrs. Peggy Bush. A wise man once told me that the key to any good graduation speech is the three B's. Be brief, be brilliant, and be seated. So in keeping with that, I don't think there's a great deal that I can add this evening that's going to make it more special, other than what we were able to hear Mr. Walters articulate with the senior biographies. I mean, it's a pretty special group of young people, but I also want the folks in the room to remember that the staff at Community High School took the time and takes the time every year to know these kids as individual people, and that's a special, special thing. On behalf of the district, I just want to continue to pledge to those here this evening and the students who are graduating that the district will continue to support our alternative education program. And in 2 years, we have some significant plans to expand it. That way, we have the opportunity to affect more children. I think in an ever-challenging society, our kids are facing a lot of adversity, and we know there's more kids than the 30 seniors up here this evening and the almost 100 students that Community High School affects each year that need the compassion, need the individual attention, and need the experience of Community High School. So with that, on behalf of the Board of Education and the Central Office Administration of Lapeer Community Schools, I want to offer my sincere and heartfelt congratulations to our graduates and also to you as families. And I want to challenge our graduates to do one thing in the next week or two as we're celebrating and spending all that scholarship money. I want you to take time to say thank you to the people out here this evening that have spent a lot of time supporting you, in helping you get to this point. I know moms and dads and grandparents and aunts and uncles and neighbors and friends. It takes a lot of people to get you to where you're at, and most of us would not be where we're at without our families. So take time to say thank you to them as well. So on behalf of the district, thank you very much and congratulations. At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce Mrs. Peggy Bush as the Lapeer Board Trustee and Board Partner for Community High School. Mrs. Bush.
I'm the short one. On behalf of Lapeer Community School Board of Education and Administration, a belated welcome to the 2013 graduation of Community High School. To the parents, families, and friends of tonight's graduates, thank you. Your love and support has been an anchor for your graduate. Your willingness to help, push, and occasionally pull your graduate to this milestone is very much appreciated. Thank you, Mr. Walters, teachers, and staff of Community High School. Your dedication and commitment to your students not only ensures that they have a strong academic base, but perhaps as importantly, you have shown them that they can be successful and that they can reach even higher than they had once thought. Confident individuals sit before you tonight, ready to move on to greater opportunities and goals. A job well done. Graduates, I have spoken of you these past few minutes as strong, confident, and ready to move to the next stage of your life, and that is where each of you are at. Tonight, you are being recognized for what you have accomplished. For some, I suspect they did not think this night would ever come, but it has. And while your parents, families, friends, and teachers have helped you in many ways, it is each of you that has made this success happen. You have shown persistence, strength, and even courage every single day. Certainly, there were some days much harder. And some days staying under the covers seemed the best idea. But you continued forward and you reached your goal, a diploma. But the diploma is only a start. Now you must use the skills taught by these teachers, the love and the support of your family and friends, and the strength that you have within you to go further, to learn even more, and to make a difference in yourself and make a difference in this world. I also ask one small favor of you, as Mr. Wandry said. Tell that person who kept you going, helped you believe in yourself even when you began to doubt that success would ever happen, thank you. And then go out and find that person who is struggling as you struggled, who doesn't see success as happening, and become their role model. It was once said, if you can imagine it, you can create it. I believe if you dream it, you will become it. Please go out with your dreams, take on the world, and the very best wishes from the Board of Education and Administration. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Wandry and Mrs. Bush, for those comments. And on behalf of the entire Community High School program, I want to thank Mr. Wandry and the board for your support and commitment to the important mission of the program, as well as the vision to and the fortitude to expand the opportunities in that program that are upcoming. Some very exciting things in the future for Community High School. Thank you again. Another tradition at Community High School is our student speakers, and we have two students who would like to share some thoughts with you tonight. Our first speaker is Ms. Catherine Mullenix.
John Lennon once said, when I was 5 years old, my mother always told me that happiness was a key to life. When I went to school, they asked me what I wanted to be when I grew up. I wrote down happy. They told me I didn't understand the assignment, and I told them they didn't understand life. In this quote, I understand that it is saying that when growing up, do what makes you happy instead of living a life doing something you hate. It doesn't matter if you go to a community college or university after high school. Life is full of opportunities for happiness that wait outside those doors. As we leave community, the closest of friends may drift, and the acquaintances may never talk again. But those people you surrounded yourself with throughout these years will always have been what influenced you to make you who you are today. I am very thankful for all the people I have met within the years. I have attended a community. I am glad to be graduating with whom I've grown up with. I'd like to thank the staff at community for all the help they have given us to make the right choices and educate us before we take our first steps into the real world, helping us strive to be everything they know we can be and all the support they had given us to stick it out till the end, knowing we can be something great. Keep your head up even when times are hard. Smile when the sun isn't shining. Have confidence in the things you do because all the hard work, the stress, and scrambling will be worth it in the end. We've had our ups and downs, take one step forward and taken two back, but we've taken a bigger leap forward, doing obstacles, going over obstacles. We've made it this far in life, surpassing struggles, proving those who had little faith in us wrong. Stand up, be proud of who you are and what you have accomplished. Today we are high school graduates. Today we go our separate ways and someday we'll meet again. We did it, class of 2013. The struggle is over.
Thank you, Catherine. She's not happy with me because I told her all the lights would be dim so you couldn't see anyone's face when you spoke yesterday. I did not lie. I think there was a malfunction out there, so thank you. It's a very difficult thing to speak in front of as my people, but very, very good, good job, Kitty. Our next speaker is Miss Lauren Young.
It is an honor to be standing here in front of all of you today. It has been a long and treacherous journey for all of us, but is nothing compared to the journey ahead. Today is our day we embark into the world and start our new lives. We came here as frightened young children, but are leaving as confident adults. Some of us will go on to college to get degrees, others will jump straight into the workforce, and some will go on to serve our beautiful country. But all of us will be on the pathway to make a future for ourselves. It is our choice to go on and do great things with that future or sit on the couch watching TV eating cheese balls. With all the moments that we encounter in our lives, momentous and mundane, we should all face them with our head held high and success in our thoughts. Whether it is going on to college to get a PhD or simply waking up in the morning to live another day, we should always appreciate the little things in life. We should always thank and remember all the people that have helped us get through that journey, all the teachers that stayed up late to help us with our homework, all the parents that force us to get up in the morning when we keep hitting snooze, and all our friends that help us get away from the stressful day and help us build our threshold for frustration. Even if life drags us apart somehow, we should never forget where we came from and all the loved ones in our lives that have helped us get to where we are now. I'd like to give a special thanks to my teacher, Mrs. Hyatt, for helping me through the hard times and making sure I never settled for anything less. I have her to thank for getting second in the state in veterinary science and going on an internship to a vet's office. These are skills that I will have with me for the rest of my life and hopefully help me in the veterinary world. I would also like to give a special thanks to Mrs. Adams for getting me more interested in sign language and teaching me what a beautiful language it is. I would not be up here signing the national anthem today if it was not for her. My fellow graduates, before I continue, we all need to give ourselves a round of applause. We've really, truly earned it. Yeah. Come on. Just look at everything we had to go through to get here. First of all, puberty. That wasn't easy. Trying to find our seat on the first day of class. Seeing which cafeteria food we were brave enough to try. Trying to pass that driving test. If only parallel parking didn't exist, maybe we would have got our license a little sooner. These are just some of the little things that tend to get pushed under the rug when everyone is so focused on test scores and college applications, trying to prepare us for the future. Unfortunately, when people hear the words alternative high school, they don't think of anything good. The words college and career never cross their mind. Most people think bad grades and dropout druggies, but we are all living proof that that is not always the case. There are many students up here today that have gotten certified in many different things that will help them be successful in life and their future careers, and many others that have already been successful in work, college, and in their family business. Now let's get on with the ceremony and keep proving those people wrong and show them what we're really capable of.
Thank you, Lauren. All right, now is the time that we've been waiting for, the presentation of diplomas, which signifies that the students before us have earned the right to stand before you and the Board of Education as Lapeer graduates and receive their diploma. Members of Lapeer Board of Education and Superintendent Wandry, on behalf of the staff at Lapeer Community High School, I hereby affirm to you that the students before you have fulfilled the requirements and expectations of the Lapeer Community School District and are therefore entitled to receive the Lapeer Community School District diploma conferred upon them this evening. Julian Tyndale, our top senior, will be reading the names of his fellow graduates as they cross the stage to receive their diploma. Please join me in both welcoming Julian back to the podium and acknowledging his accomplishments as our top graduating senior this year.
Lauren Marie Young. Laura Faye Ruffner. Catherine A. Mullenix. Cammie Tayanne Carpenter. Samantha Marie Canoy. Samantha Phyllis Williams. Justin Marie Cervinerich. Sarah Joyce Kathleen Ball. Ashley Morey. Kimberly R. Vanderford. Francesca McAlvey. Rachel E. Palmer. Chelsea Sue Wilson. Raynell Jane Flansburg. Jacob Hartwell. A. Edward Hembry. Chaz Pridemore. Joshua A. Yax. Mason Rule. Jesse Dwayne Moore. Joseph A. Engel. Aaron W. Thornsberry. Kenneth J. Wood, Jr. Randall W. Chastain. Marcus James McClone. Zachary Aaron Dinsmore. Cody Michael Rumble. Dominic V. Verisco. John Nick Tapp.
Julian Michael Tyndale. It gives me great pleasure and a sense of true honor in representing Lapeer Community High School staff, to present the Lapeer Community High School graduating class of 2013. Graduates, move your tassels and congratulations.